Hey there guys, and welcome back to the playthrough of Mel's Story, playing on the Mac version of the Steam release. Well, I say Steam release, it was only a Steam release, there is no like hard copy, unfortunately. And it feels incredibly weird, you have no idea, switching between computers like this, play different games. I mean, I could play this on the PC version as well, but I don't know. I still quite like screen flow as recording software. Oh no, increasing the difficulty again.
Difficulty this time? I'm sure it can handle it. Just make sure to dodge the bullets again.
Yeah, not dying, always helpful there, Virgil. Cheers, bud. I still can't get out, unfortunately. But yes, I started on the Mac, I just like the extra options for editing and things I have with ScreenFlow. At least for the audio, anyhow. Mojave, which is what I'm using on my PC. It's basically designed as a competitor for ScreenFlow, so a lot of the functionality is exactly the same. Except for the audio. The audio only has very, very basic editing functions. But you can increase the volume and change the speed, and that's about it. So I'm having to do what a lot of people do and edit my audio via Audacity, which is incredibly weird. I have to like record everything and then take my audio footage out, audio commentary rather, out, run it through Audacity to clean it up, increase the volume, etc., etc. Then plug it back into the video, make sure that it's all still properly aligned, and then produce the video, and perhaps enhance the sound, which is like the only thing that Mojave really allows you to do. Whereas in ScreenFlow, I can do all of that within the one program, which is a lot simpler, to be quite frank. It's generally a lot easier. I mean, technically speaking, the options you get in ScreenFlow aren't quite as advanced as those offered by Audacity. I mean, I am limited in that regard, but to be quite frank, the effects that I generally apply to sounds are all very, very simple, ultimately speaking, so I don't really need more than ScreenFlow offers. I don't need all of the fancy dancy options that Audacity would allow me to have. So I don't know, it's a bit of a weird one. Let's just leave it at that. Okay. So I need to go up there, stand on the platform, and then move my cube, presumably. And that will allow me to leave? Yeah? Okay, we're good. That was a lot simpler than expecting.
New test chamber. Escape contingency not in place.
Haha.
Good. Looks like it doesn't know where the elevator is heading to. Up ahead are the overgrown parts of the facility. I can try to reroute the elevator again if it holds up. There is an office area nearby from the same time period when Aegis was first installed. Maybe we can get some information from there.
Maybe. Yeah, I suppose you get used to seeing blue screens again, didn't I?
So, I was right! When a test subject destroyed her, this whole place fell into disrepair. I don't exactly know if everything is working properly anymore, but we don't have a choice.
Error. Tracking on target failed. Heavy organic interference.
Really? You can't disturb
it's
me from a plant?
Here.
I mean, I know Mel was in a vegetative state, but even so.
There's some stuff here blocking the path for the elevator. Hold on for emergency brakes!
I am braced. Well, that was slightly underwhelming.
I'm out of here, and let's get moving.
Sounds like a plan. That was incredibly underwhelming there, Virgil. Alright, now I'm boardwalking. Or pipe walking.
That was close.
You despawned that.
Oh, wait, you just were.
No way that fell that quickly. I know your game. Game. Whatever. There are words in there, I knew what I meant. God, the bodies of turrets everywhere. Water? Water. Well, I say water, probably toxic slush during my luck.
Offices I was talking about before. The humans left these behind when she gassed them with neurotoxin.
You playing the pronoun game there, Virgil.
It's no longer connected to the rest of the computer systems. Aegis shouldn't be able to lock us out here. These computers should contain a lot of useful information for us.
Where are you talking? Oh, there you are. You were in the walls.
Alright, time to start hacking into these systems. Let's start guessing passwords. Password.
Really? You're gonna repeat the joke verbatim?
Oh, come on! Let me in.
Yep, apparently you are. Okay, that's the thing you're doing.
Passwords generated by super geniuses? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6?
Do you know if anyone actually does that anymore?
All these passwords are usually the same.
Even my parents don't do that.
0000.
Ah. They're ridiculously tech unsavage.
Just override the admin controls.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, I think there's some info here about Pegasus. I'll keep working, long as you keep going. So, get back to the testing track and get started.
Will do. Potato poster.
I'll let you know. I won't be able to move around much. Magma trails are kind of non-existent here. Unless I want to fall off another one and end up back in the junkyard.
I'm going all the way back down there for you. Plus, isn't the junkyard, like, underwater by now?
A lot of information stored in these computers. It'll take me some time to sort through these and come up with a plan so we can get rid of Aegis. According to the systems, the toxic goo is still rising. You should continue to move through the tests and upwards. Keep your feet dry.
Sounds like a plan to me. Prefer not to drown and die. It's, not on my bucket list. Oh god. Gaps. Things. Emancipation grids everywhere. Cubes to be found. I'm presuming cube, yeah, cube. Also can't actually get it out of there just yet, so I need to turn that grid off first. Ooh, lasers. Deadly lasers, presumably. Let's go check it out. Aha, yep, that's definitely a laser. Needs to go over there, though. But I need to get over there. Okay, so laser goes into panel. To do that, we need to go blip and blip. I said blip and blip, which turns that off. Well, that worked out. Of course, I can't use any portals right now. I can get my cube to freedom. Well, sort of freedom. Well, there's a button up there, so I can put it on the button. See what that does. That sounds right. Okay, put you there for a moment. Stop getting lasered in the spine as I try and do this. Right, you. Ow. Please, spacebar. Spacebar, please. Try again. Aha! Success! Of a sort. Okay, that goes on there. Aha! So I can now... What can I do? I suppose I could push myself over the edge. Like go toward the next area? At the moment I do, I'm gonna go for an emancipation grid. Let's just look at it for the sake of looking at it. Does this seem right to you? That's going to take me straight through the emancipation grid, isn't it? Might even just drop me straight into the water. Get that cube down, I guess. Wouldn't that just push it straight into the emancipation grid as well? Okay. Doesn't seem, too useful. Let's give it a go. Yep, just push it straight into the grid. Okay. I can catch it from the sides. I said I can catch it from the... There we go. And then... Can I move it? I can! Okay. I can move it over here, can't I? So, 1, 2, 3, 4... Am I close enough now? Or if I crouch, it might help. There we go. Okay, I've got two cubes here now. And I can redirect the lasers without using portals. Which means I can keep the funnel active. Without needing to use the portals. Which means I can go through the emancipation grid. No wait, that's not the funnel, is it? That just keeps the upper emancipation grid down. Why did that fall off? Okay, whatever. Get back over there. Okay, so I can turn this back on and leave it on permanently. No, no, stop it. Stop it. There we go. So I've got this turned on permanently now. Which means I can... That's all that's really left, is me to go over the other side, isn't it? It does seem to be pretty much my only real option at this point. Okay, I guess I can do that. Again, I'm not entirely certain what the point is just yet. It's definitely something I can do. Okay. Let's give it a go. I swear to God, if this just drops me straight into the sludge or something daft like that, I'm not going to be impressed. Okay, go, 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 go. Okay, and this turns off the grid. Okay. So I can get back and forth whenever I like. From either side of the grid. And I don't need... actually, no way. Yes, I don't need the funnel, which means I can just go, yeah, straight through there. We're good. Okay, so that... No. That turns the grid off permanently. So I can now freely portal back and forth across both sides. I'm going to need... Presumably I'm going to need both cubes, because there are two buttons behind me. So... If I just go... It can't be that simple, surely. Is it really just going to let me take... He says almost buggering it up, you know, instantly. Of course he does. Is he actually going to let me do this? Apparently it is. Then just take that and put that on there. Is that... Yeah, apparently that's it. Cool. That was... Yeah. That wasn't too bad.
I sorted through some of the stuff. So many cat pictures. But I also got some more serious information. Aegis thinks we killed the scientists. So it's activating some sort of kill order. It's going to flood the enrichment center, probably with all that goo, to eliminate any and all threats. That means you, that means me, and that means whatever that last thing is. So I'd suggest we keep moving.
Fair enough. So it's like a purposely killbot version of GLaDOS. That's, isn't that just delightful? Get myself over the other side safely. That's a start. Though to what purpose? Is always the question. I can... Can't get anything out of there just yet. Ooh, I see panels. I see panels. Right. So I'm in the right position to actually... There we go. That, like that. Aha! Viva la freedom! Viva la freedom! The question remains of how exactly do I get over there without getting my arse killed? Most puzzling. Most puzzling indeed. Okay. You want me to... Do I need to get the light bridge? I might need to go and get the light bridge back. I'll say back, you know, just... As in, over here. Then transition... That way. I think that's gonna be the simplest way of doing this. So I need the... Actually, wait. I need to be, like, standing over there to do this, though, don't I? So I don't think I can jump far enough to get back... onto the light bridge from here. Let's give it a go. The worst that happens is we fail. Actually, the worst that happens is we die. Potato, potato at this point. Death state and failure state are essentially the same thing when you're playing this style of game. Because yeah, if I could probably get it from standing like on this side, but if I do that, I'm going to fall into the muck and die. Rather horribly, I might add. So I have to be standing here. And I should just about be able to do it, actually, if I time this right. Did it work? I think it worked. Yes! Success! Success and victory! Just how it was meant to be! Success and victory! Excellent. Okay, now we're up top. Or on this side. We'll find it with... Ooh, what does this button do? Ah, splashes goo everywhere. Of course it does. Bouncy. Now I can get back without needing the light bridge. That's my first start. Okay, that should be plenty. Just splatter the floor in goo. If in doubt, apply goo to everything. I'm just gonna splatter it everywhere and assume that it makes sense. Yeah, I guess that works for something. Get a better look at this. Oh, I can make super bouncy walls, of course I can, so I can get right and get up top. Which means those are portable surfaces so I can bounce up and I can take the cube out that way. Aha, good thinking, Batman. Good thinking. It's a little bit awkward doing this, but bouncy. Splatter. Okay, that should cover everything. More or less enough, I think. Yeah, I should be fine. Right. Drop down here, jump through here. So I can bounce up top. Take the cube out. Okay, that's easy enough. I need to do this first, don't I? Whee! Let's aim carefully. Drop that down there. And if I can remember how you do this. Just angle, and there we go. Just weird how you, like, instantly drop, though. Right, here we go. Bounce. Oh, come on, you're kidding me, right? Why am I slightly the wrong angle to do this? Okay, a little bit higher. That should be fine. Okay, start again. Bouncy, and... Really? This is what we're doing, is it? This is apparently what we're doing. The game reckons I'm somehow not able to go through the portal, despite flying directly at it. Really? If I put it this side? No, I just instantly fall if I put it that side, apparently. Nope. Through the portal. Please, dear Lord, just go. You're hitting your face directly on it. Please go through the portal. Oh, you son of a bitch. Really? That's what we're doing, is it? That's what we're doing. Okay, I'm gonna kill you. Okay. No, don't fall. Go through the portal. Please. Dear Lord, that took far too long. Where's my cube? My cube's down there. Oh my god, you have no idea how ridiculously long that took. Okay. Actually, of course you do. You're watching. What have I been saying? You're watching this. Of course you know. Okay, I need to get over there. So, lots of bouncy. And then I make a light bridge and I bounce off that up onto the platform. Problem solved. Okay. You come down here, Sunny Jim. Yellow over there, but orange, whatever. Onto the light bridge. A few down there for a sec so I can make sure I'm lined up for this jump. Yeah, that should be fine. Okay, we're looking good. Bouncy, and... Really? No, don't you dare drop me into the goo. Stop it. Please. I'm hitting all the buttons. Please stop. There we go. Okay. Let's try that again. Blue, I guess. Takes me back out there. So I go... Hmm. get a better angle of this. Oh god, that's not gonna work. Nope, stop. Stop. Thank you. Right. Bounce, there we go. Back up here. Put that over there. Okay. Back onto this. Through here. Now with a bit more gymnastics. Make sure we don't hit the cube as we do this. Whee! Okay, there we go. Don't think that should have taken that long, but we got through it in the end. Like I say, to make up for the fact that I haven't recorded any of this in a while, I'm going to sit here and do like a mammoth session. That's the plan anyhow. Ah, thank God for ginger ale. Need to wet my whistle. Ah, oh, feels better. I did like a whole bunch of Thief before I did this as well. It's just the way it works out these days. Just less and less hours left to actually do recordings of things. You know, if I want to actually have it out there. Just play games for myself and things. Like, I'm barely out of the beginning area of Witcher.
Recalibrating sensors.
Well, it seems that we won't be able to stay in the plant field test chambers much longer. It seems to be able to adapt to our actions quite well. We need to come up with a plan to take him on, head on. But leave that to me. You can continue solving these tests.
Sounds like a plan. Okay. What do the buttons do? What do all the buttons do? That reverses the polarity of the neutron flow. This one summons forth a cube all the way over there. Surprisingly not. No. That's not inside the panel like I assumed it would be. Whee! No. No. I think it got slightly behind the funnel, actually. It's really awkwardly angled, so you can't entirely see what's going on. Okay. Whatever does it for you, I guess. Okay, that summons that. That pulls that up. God damn it. Well, it's stuck over there now. That's a thing. How do I get you back? Just could pull you over this way, maybe? That gonna work? Right, wait for it. Wait for it. And now! Excellent. Now if I just rearrange the portal, you should drop. There we go. My little cubist friend. There we go. Now I should be able to pull myself up over there by putting a portal on the far wall and reversing the flow. Yes? Let's find out, shall we? I think this is... Nope. I'm actually standing in it. Yep, there you go. Okay. So I'm through. I'm assuming I just need to retrieve my my cube from up here somehow. Question of how. Definitely, however, the big one. Because. I need to get the cube back up here. How do I do this exactly? Let's get the cube into a position where it's being. Like, pushed or pulled into the right place? I'm sure that one over there is the only one that goes near the door. So we need to go through there, ultimately. I think. Okay. Can I move? I assume I can move the cube with the funnels like I did earlier. That seems fairly self-evident. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So I can move the cube without actually having to touch it, that's a start. Question still becomes how exactly though. Let's put that over there for a moment, just while I think about this. If needs be, I can get myself back down there by jumping into that one. There's gotta be something to do with me being able to move the cube. I can change. I can use the portals to change the flow of direction of these things. But there's pretty clearly a button over there, so I need the cube up here as well. How does one do that? Although, I wonder. I mean, a lot of these test chambers that have been set up where that, once you've activated the cube button once, destroying the cube will automatically cause another one to spawn. I mean, it happened in the chamber we were just in. But it doesn't always happen, though. Which leaves me curious. I mean, if I kill that cube down there, will another one spawn up here with me? I mean, if that's the case, then things become a bit simpler to figure out now, don't they? If that isn't the case, then I could end up all sorts of fucked. I'm afraid I'm just gonna really have to just give it a go. I don't really see any way around this. Moving the cube is pretty much my only option as I see it. Okay. I don't really buy this is gonna work, but there's plenty of toxic sludge down there to give it a go with. Okay, yeah. See if this drops or not. Move that over there, and wait for it. I'm sorry, my little friend. The sacrifice will not be in vain. Ah, why? Holy shit, it worked. Okay, and then, I just fly through the portals. Is that really that simple? Yeah, it's gonna drop me off by the button. Okay. Okay, that actually works. Nice. Couldn't be happier. Well, could be, but you know. Shouldn't complain.
Hey, Mel!
You have no idea how hard it is to move around here. Anyway, remember those old turks from all the way at the bottom of the facility?
Nah.
Those guys have no security systems installed. It should be really easy to reprogram them to destroy aliens instead of humans. If we go down to a turret production line, we might be able to produce friendly turrets.
Well, I do prefer the friendly versions, gotta say. Okay. I can interrupt the laser grid, but why do I want to interrupt the laser grid? What does that actually accomplish? Not an awful lot, as far as I can see. Oh, it turns that off. Okay. It turns the emancipation grid off to my right. This changes... okay. That changes funnel direction. You know, I'm going to need to get up there at some point. Okay. It's all slowly becoming clear. Clear as mud. But still, clear nonetheless. Okay. Okay. I mean, I know this is probably isn't the most exciting bit for you guys. The bit where I'm just basically guessing what's going on. I don't think I even need to do this, but I'm going to do it anyway. Just to muck around and experiment and see what different ways I can traverse the area. Okay. So I presume I can drop a cube. Yep, into the water, so that's what I need the funnel for. I can use the funnel to pull my cube to safety. Yes? Yes. Okay. Cube is safe. And put that on there. And that... well, that deactivates that permanently. Okay. That's a start. That's a good start, actually, yeah. Okay. But that's not entirely what I need, though, is it? I need... so many things. Huh. Now that. That pushes that back up there. But I need the cube on this side. Yeah, okay. Okay. But the moment I move the cube, it's going to turn the emancipation grid back on, which means I can't get the cube to where it needs to be after that. I could go for ham right now. I could go for anything right now. I'm bloody starving. And I'm out of ginger ale as well, apparently. What a crying shame that is. Okay. Yeah, I'm still utterly confused as to what the game actually wants me to do at this point. Utterly is the wrong word, but I am generally speaking confused. Yeah, keep that. Okay, that keeps that turned off. As long as the laser is blocked. Okay. Can I move my portals this way, perhaps? See if this works. And then... this might work, actually. This might work. Because if I... this should... You know what, fuck it. Let's just give it a go. We'll assume it's gonna work. Should be fine. Right, if I put that over there, then if I drop a orange over here to move that through there. Okay. If I put an orange on the grid here, I should pull that through onto there. Okay. Now we're getting somewhere. Put it on blue. I said put it on blue. Start in. No, damn it all. Blue and mine. Okay. Pop that on there. Now I just step into the portal and. Bada bing, bada boom! Winner! Okay. Just gonna get rid of my portals, but I'm on the next side, so we're good. I need lasers, I need more cubes. I always need more cubes in my life. Tend to find that. Okay. So I now have a laser redirectional cube. And this one turns the grid off. Now is that permanent or is that timed? I'm not hearing a ticking, ticking counter. No, I think that's permanent. Okay. Okay. So we now have access to the upper echelons of this place whenever I want. That's a good start. Okay. Which means I could redirect a laser from down there, I guess? So, I'm really paranoid about this now. The last time I did stuff like this, it turned out to be a troll, and yeah. The laser cube wasn't actually supposed to be used for redirection at all, it was just another cube to be used to weigh things down with. I turned off the emancipation grid on that side. Okay. Hockey. Hockey. Okay. The question remains, what do I do with... I mean, clearly I still need to activate something. I'm totally certain what, actually, though. Doesn't seem to be any more buttons or switches anywhere. I suppose there's one right on the opposite side there, but even so. That really won't activate the button from like the very start of the level. It seems a little cruel. A little pointless too, in fact. But that's... yeah, the dots are on the ceiling. They're pretty much going in that direction. Is that really it? My phone's going off as well. One sec. Okay, we're back again. Sorry about that. To go answer a few messages. What were we even doing? Oh god, I've actually forgotten. I think I have. We were... oh god, seriously, what were we doing? What? Something to do with a button. Alright, button over there. Right, okay. That was it, wasn't it? I need to figure out a way to actually reactivate that button. I'm pretty convinced that the redirectional cube is actually a troll. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to actually use it to weigh stuff down. Just, I don't see any way the game's going to let me get away with that. So I'm going to pop that on there for a moment. I don't know, should I try and see if I can reactivate the laser grid using just the laser and see if that works first? That do it? Yeah, that works. Okay. So I can do that. I can... oh, it's just so frustrating when you think you've got an idea of why and how things should work, but you're not entirely certain. Just to get myself... no, that's wrong. Yep, that's just entirely... entirely wrong, okay. Wait, if I do that, it's going to move my new fancy cube. Now, I'm not going through all the crap I had to go through already just to get that cube back. Just be over there for a second. God, I really hope this works. I don't want to go through that all over again. Okay, so I'm back here. Yes, I'm back here. If I do that and that. And you come with me and go there, I think. Yeah, the little tick box next to the door is just lit up. So this is right, it does need to be active. Still in the top right of my screen. Okay. But, and it's a big but, and I cannot lie. I'm not sure if that's entirely the... I think I might be missing something. Okay, I'll put you there. You... I want everything active, basically, is what I'm saying. I think that's what I have to do. So I don't think I can get back up top unless everything is properly active. So you go there. Then cube from here goes on the switch that we were just using. No, wait. No. You come here. There. You go back on there. You follow me back over here and drop on... oh, no, come on. Come on. On there. Okay, so now I just use the portals to redirect the deadly lasers. Game, please. Game, please. Game, please. Seriously, don't even try it. I know I can do this. There we go. Bloody scenery everywhere. And that goes on there. Ow, 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 ow. Jump, please, Mel. Okay, then Lou goes over there like so.
Well done. Test subjects rated that as one of the hardest tests in this track. I heard that it was made by two particularly cruel scientists.
Good job they're all dead then, eh? Okay, I'm actually going to stop there because my throat's going bandy as well, so thank you for watching. See you next time, guys.